Welcome back to Straight Facts by Dinar Investor.
Good morning and happy Sunday to everyone. Hope everyone's doing well. Thank you to everyone for taking time out of your day yesterday to watch the Cloud 2.0 video and what it could do for you. And thank you to everyone who signed up. Going forward, I'm going to do videos on both the Dinar and regarding Cloud to help everyone out who signed up and kind of, you know, introduce you to all the new changes. And there's new changes coming up. So there's also conference calls that occur with that. And there's a private messaging group on that. So I'm going to share that with everyone that's involved so you can stay informed and stay up to speed with that product. When that product was first introduced to me, I had every single one of you guys in mind. You guys know I don't reach out and charge you guys for anything. That's not who I am. Every single one of us work very hard for our money. And my goal is for everyone to be financially secure and blessed regarding your future. So that's when it was introduced to me and I had a chance to see how it worked, how it's completely free and you can put Bitcoin in it and receive gains ranging from 6 to 12% monthly. You guys definitely came to my mind. And what came to my mind was this part is my opinion and should not be used for financial advice. What came to me was this: we're all Dinar investors and a lot of the other Dinar groups and forums strongly promote cryptocurrency. Okay. Well, what that means is that a lot of them, even after the rate change, will spend some of their Dinar returns or some of their post rate change funds on crypto. Okay. Well, let's look ahead down the road. We're obviously a little ways out. Again, this is my opinion. It should not be used for financial advice. In my opinion, we're a little ways out. We could have maybe another 5 more months to go around maybe Marchish or something like that. So here's the deal. Timing is everything. Timing's critical. Most people that have become very successful and wealthy in life, it's because they had timing in their favor. That was part of how they achieved their wealth, was based on making the right move at the right time. Okay. Well, what if you got invested in the cloud, you put your $600 in so you could receive all of the different rewards offered, both passive and shared rewards. And then let's say most of your referrals and your referrals, let's say most of them are Dinar investors. Okay. So you're invested, you put your 600 in, you're correctly positioned. And then you've got your referrals. They have their referrals. Guys, when the rate changes, you just positioned yourself perfectly because you're going to receive a percentage from your referrals. And if they turn around and invest anywhere from tens of thousands to a few hundreds of thousands of dollars in cryptocurrency and let it invest and earn gains, you know, ranging from 6 to 12% after the rate change, do you have any idea what you guys just did for yourselves? You just positioned your future tremendously. I mean, you are very well positioned after that, because now you're going to restart receiving a percentage from them. Guys, this is huge. That's why when this was shared with me, a light bulb turned on in my head and I said, wow, I got to reach out and get this shared with these guys. Okay. So going forward, I'll be doing videos for both Cloud and the Dinar. So I'm going to still help you guys out on every level. We're going to reach the finish line. But my goal here, guys, was to get you guys positioned, because timing is everything.
Shabender calls on demonstrators to return to their homes. Your uprising was kidnapped October 26, 2019. Honorable Iraqis, go home. Your uprising has been hijacked as we expected, Shabender said in a tweet on Twitter. Do not reclaim your blood and fuel in the dirty political struggle for power and theft. 63 people killed in Iraq protests in 2 days. Sadr Bloc aligned with the opposition October 26, 2019. Sunday, October 27, 2019 demonstrations continued in Baghdad and a number of Iraqi cities on Saturday evening. In an open sit in the Iraqi parliament, 6 people were killed on Saturday in renewed protests in Iraq, including 3 demonstrators in Baghdad, according to an official toll, and 3 people shot by the protection of a local official in the south of the country. According to security and medical sources, The death toll from the 2 days of protests in Iraq, on Friday and Saturday, 63 dead in Baghdad and southern areas, according to the Iraqi Commission for Human Rights. The UNHCR said on Saturday that the highest toll from clashes since Friday was recorded in Dhekar and Misan provinces. On Saturday's victims, a member of the Iraqi Commission for Human Rights, Ali Al-Bayati, said that 6 people were killed, 3 in Baghdad and 3 in Nasiriya in the south, while police also pointed to 17 wounded in Nasiriya. According to security and medical sources in Nasiriya, the 3 people were shot dead while protesters stormed the house of the head of the security committee in the city and set it on fire. Police said a group of protesters emerged from among thousands gathered in central Nasiriya and stormed the home of a local official. She said the guards fired at the protesters after storming the building, sources told Al Arabiya on Saturday evening that security forces forcibly evicted demonstrators from Baghdad's Tahrir Square and used tear gas canisters, killing 3 people and injuring 84 people. The protesters. For its part, the Iraqi parliament announced the postponement of its session, Saturday, because of the lack of quorum, and the council announced the convening of the said meeting, on Friday, to discuss the demands of protesters. In turn, the Iraqi Interior Ministry announced on Saturday that the demonstrations that swept the country, Friday, deviated from its course. A spokesman for the Interior Ministry said in a statement that the ministry will hold accountable anyone who assaulted public institutions and promised to impose severe penalties on those who committed abuses, pointing out that the assault on property has nothing to do with peaceful protest. In turn, the Joint Operations Command in the country broke its silence, saying that there were those who took advantage of the demonstrations that came out to demand rights guaranteed by the Iraqi constitution and worked to kill and injure citizens, and to burn public and private property after looting. The command said in its first official statement that the security forces in all sectors will deal with what they described as criminals firmly in accordance with the anti-terrorism law, noting that these illegal acts are a crime that must be dealt with immediately in the field and urgent. The leadership also warned against tampering with the security of citizens. The Joint Operations Command statement stressed that strict measures will be taken against those who do not belong to peaceful demonstrators, calling on demonstrators to report these elements and not to allow them to be present in their ranks. It is noteworthy that the protests renewed in Baghdad and other provinces witnessed bloody clashes in the first day, during which killed and wounded, most of them in the southern provinces, died as a result of the use of security forces' live bullets. A curfew was imposed in 6 southern Iraqi provinces to preserve the lives of citizens and public and private property. The Iraqi government, in turn, sent troops from the counterterrorism service to southern provinces, where they witnessed Dhekar and Misan clashes between angry demonstrators and members of Asaib al-Haq, who opened fire on the protesters and killed and wounded on the pretext of trying to storm the offices of the militia. The government also authorized the southern governors to impose a state of emergency and reorganize the ranks, according to developments that the Interior Ministry said. Attacks carried out by armed parties against its forces forced the government to impose a curfew in a number of southern provinces. Gov/'s Salaries of Top Officials, October 27, 2019 in Politics, Security by John Lee. The Iraqi government has said it will reduce the salaries of ministers, members of parliament, and senior officials by up to 50% and invest the money saved in a new social security fund to support Iraqis in need. In a statement on Friday, it also announced the establishment of a special anti-corruption court to expedite the process of holding to account all those who engage in corruption. Death toll in Iraq protests rises to 63. With more than 2,000 injured. October 26, 2019, the death toll of the protests in Iraqi cities has risen to more than 60 dead and 2,000 wounded. The death toll of the protests in Iraqi cities has risen to more than 60 dead and 2,000 wounded. According to news agencies, the Iraqi Commission for Human Rights counted 63 people killed and more than 2,000 others injured during the past 48 hours. Protesters in the Iraqi capital Baghdad, Nasiriya and Basra began to demonstrate from Thursday evening, in protest against the poor living conditions. The protests are the second of its kind this month, with several Iraqi cities recently witnessing protests that have killed 157 people and wounded 6,000. The protests pose the biggest challenge to Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi since he came to power just a year ago, despite his pledge of reforms and a major cabinet reshuffle. Protesters accused corrupt officials and the political elite of failing to improve their lives. Reuters, Abdul Mahdi ordered the counter-terrorism service to end demonstrations 27/10/2019, 12:55 a.m. Baghdad News. 2 security sources told Reuters on Saturday that Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi ordered anti-terrorism forces to deploy in the streets of Baghdad and take the necessary measures to end the protests. The sources pointed out that a memo issued by Abdul Mahdi to the commander of the Iraqi elite to fight terrorism, asking him to deploy his forces and use all necessary measures to end the protests in Baghdad. For his part, said a source in Baghdad, Security forces gave the demonstrators through loudspeakers half an hour to evacuate Tahrir Square before starting to storm, or else they will be treated as outlaws. He added, the demonstrators are still trying to cross the Bridge of the Republic and access to the Green Zone, indicating that significant military security reinforcements arrived there.